Moving on to my thought of the week this week, and very simple, guys, and with everything we talked about, and I think it's very fitting with Gabrielle Bernstein in Judgment Detox, and choosing love and forgiveness over judgment and fear. And I think I've talked about this before. It's, you got to practice this stuff. It's something that we, you can't just talk the talk. You have to really practice it, and it's not easy. And I do different little practices, which you heard in the conversation, where I verbally go through things, I visually do some things when I do my, my little meditation every day or my affirmations, and I practice, and it sometimes it doesn't feel good, because sometimes we want to hold on to the hate and the anger, or we think we have to, and but it doesn't benefit us. It only hurts us, and it takes a truly special person to overcome that, as the majority of the world is filled with negativity and judgment and fear and hate and criticism, and it takes a lot of self-reflection, a lot of work with everything going on too, with this period and everyone being forced to kind of sit at home. Everyone's used to distracting themselves, whether it's going out, whether it's watching TV or movies all the time, whether it's saying you got to go hang out with your friends, this and that. Humans have become very good at distracting themselves and avoiding knowing themselves, and because they don't know where to start. There's so many negative emotions in people, and you really, and I've been on this quest of reading and learning and trying to evolve. You got to just face the fucking mirror, man. You got to just look yourself in the mirror, and you got to say, well, this is only going to hurt me negatively. And I've talked with Gabriel, it's come in stages for me. Even the law of attraction and positivity, it can only take you so far. There's all these other things, and judgment is one of these things that came in the later stages for me. And I found too that sometimes when you're more successful or you have more money, it can make you more judgmental. And I don't want to say look down on people, but we see that with a lot of people that have more success. They're some of the most judgmental people, but often too, people that struggle are the most and very poor, angry, upset. They're very judgmental. It's truly a broad scale spectrum here of all of us having judgment, and it's becoming aware of it. It's forgiving yourself for being judgmental. It's going to happen. You're going to see something. You're going to go, fuck them. That fucking piece of shit. Whatever it is. It's catching yourself and then forgiving yourself for being judgmental and choosing love and forgiveness and practicing it. And you know what? I forgive that person. I'm going to move on. I have no hate, no anger, no resentment towards them. It's really difficult to do. But if you can do it, it takes time. You got to keep practicing it like anything else. It takes patience and persistence, guys, as with anything. I promise you, and I've done it, it gets a lot easier. I would see things and I'd get very angry, very, and it's done me well in different aspects of life. But it's when you're not in a fight element or acting where you're pretending to fight, where you need that real energy or to tap into anger, real anger that you have, it doesn't really benefit you outside of that. And that's something that I found that in trying to be successful in so many other areas of life outside of just wrestling, that you really, really got to have your mental game up to par, up to snuff. And judgment, choose love and forgiveness over judgment and fear. That's my thought of the week, guys.
Hey guys, it's the Big Guy Ryback, and I just want to say thank you very much for watching. Go ahead and punch that like, smash that subscribe button, and check out my all-natural my all-natural supplement line, Feed Me More Nutrition, available on Amazon and feedmemore.com. And as always, Conversation with the Big Guy Ryback, available on all podcast platforms, iTunes, Google Play, SoundCloud, and wherever podcasts are available. Never forget, Feed Me More.